This video is brought to you by Akita Natural Skincare Products. Check out the description box for more details. Yourself more comfortable, I will prepare the room and I'll explain to you in more detail what this treatment entails and why it is so exquisite for the skin. So again, just make yourself comfortable. I'm just placing some flowers on the table. And the reason why I am doing this now is because I would like the rose petals to be as fresh as possible. There is something about the scent of roses that I just simply find very soothing. And I hope you don't mind some of the music that I am playing. It's only to add a relaxing ambiance. And it will slowly fade away when we begin with the treatment. Now that I have you sitting at the table, petals, I would like you to gently place your hands on them and I would like you to take a deep breath, inhale and exhale gently. And the reason is because I want you to just been a long, stressful day. You've worked very hard, and this time is for you. And the treatment that I am going to be performing on your beautiful skin works a lot better if you are relaxed. You see, when using rose oil or natural ingredients, they work best when your skin is resting. and they cannot do their work. So just take a moment, just breathe in the scent of roses and enjoy the very soft pink color. Enjoy the music and enjoy the sounds of the rain. I am always complimenting you on your beautiful hair. And in the past, you have tied up your hair in a neat ponytail or something else, and I would be very happy if you can provide me with some feedback. And I would like to try a shower cap. And the reason being is because with the ponytail or a hair bun, sometimes it can leave the scalp a little bit sore or with some discomfort, because in order for the hairdo to stay up, sometimes we have to really tighten up the hairband. And so in order to avoid that discomfort, you're going to have your hair loose, but neatly bundled underneath the shower cap. And of course, order to stay within the theme of roses, this shower cap is decorated with teeny tiny pink roses. So even though I am not going to be applying any rose oil on your hair, your beautiful mane is going to be covered with roses. Okay, so I just need you to gather all your hair and I'll place the shower. Wonderful. And the colors, they really suit you. Now, let's begin with the treatment. So, we're going to begin with two items. And that is the makeup remover and face wash. They are both very similar. The only difference is on the application. And the reason I'm going to try both on your skin is because I would like you to have the best of both worlds. And later on, you can choose whichever one you prefer. Now, for the makeup remover, we are going to need some cotton pads. And the way it works is you can dampen your face with either water or a facial toner. Instead of water, I'm going to use a rose water toner. So when you're ready, please close your eyes. And just a little bit on the cotton pad. Just going to dip it in the makeup remover. And close your eyes again for me, please. I'm going to start the forehead, okay, a little bit more for the eyelids and the eyebrows and the mascara. Okay, there you go. And you'll notice that the product has a very earthy smell. On your nose, there we go. Now the cheekbones. See? Now for the rest of the cheeks and you'll notice that it's very smooth on the skin. Go. And now you do have the option to wipe it with a very soft clean cloth or with another cotton pad. And because I would like you to try on the face wash, I'm going to spray some more rose water and then apply the face wash. Close your eyes for me, please. Now, the face wash, in comparison to the makeup remover, this does lather a little bit. Just going to apply some. Starting at the forehead and under just try it yourself a little bit, follow the same steps, and I'm going to apply some on your hands so your hands are thoroughly clean. You can massage your face and feel the texture and the consistency of the products. Okay. So, I'm just gonna add some toner on your hands. Again, applying some face wash and just gently massage it onto your hands, and you notice that it's not stripping away any moisture from your skin. In fact, it's adding more to it. Now, I'm going to add more toner to your face, and I'm going to use this pink towel to wipe away any debris from your skin. Gently, I'm just going to pat underneath the eyes very gently. Just gently patting. Good. And now the nose. And those beautiful. Some more rose toner on your hands. Okay. There you go. Gently wiping the soap from your skin. Great. As you already noticed, these are very easy to use, and your skin is already glowing, and we're not even halfway through the treatment, so this is wonderful to see. As I've said already, this love these products on my skin. And now I'm going to show you two other items which are absolutely beautiful, and you'll see why. Inside this gold bag, there is an item that is worth its weight in gold. it is something that is very opulent, luxurious, and it comes from a very far away land. Many, many rose petals are required in producing this fairy. Can you imagine hundreds upon hundreds of rose petals are needed just to create this teeny tiny amount of rose oil? And this amount is one treatment. The good news is, because it is 100% rose oil, you only need to use tiny amounts on your skin to reap. Use it on a daily basis until you run out, and then you have to wait to obtain a teeny tiny container of rose oil. Now, most rose oils out there are mixed with carrier oils, and understandably so. And so over here, I have poured some rose oil, and then here I have some face cream, which also contains rose oil. So you are receiving an unbelievable amount of rose oil. And this is the reason why I would like you to just enjoy your stay with us. Just continue to relax. Continue to take and keep in mind that you deserve this, because this treatment is only for a selected few. And I would like you to remind yourself of how wonderful you are. Now, what I'm going to do, the rose oil will be applied on your face, and the face cream I'll apply it on your hands, and I can also apply some face cream on certain areas of your skin just so that you can feel the difference. But the rose oil is so potent, and that's the reason why I would like you to try it more, just for now. So, please close. for me. And your face is already slightly damp from the face wash, so I'm only gonna apply a little bit of rose toner. Just a mist. Start on the forehead, under the eyes, and the nose, just a little bit more, and again, just very small amounts. This goes a very some face cream on your hands. Go. And this is quite thick. It is very hydrating. So on those days that the weather is just simply too dry for your skin, this would be perfect. And now, let's apply just a little bit on your cheekbones. There you go. Just feel it with your fingertips. See, it feels oily, but it doesn't feel greasy. And the other thing you'll notice is that the face cream does have a bit of a cooling sensation. And as it dries up, especially on your hands, your as it dries up, it has a matte finish. So your skin has this gliding texture. And because you can use it for daytime or nighttime, in the daytime, because it doesn't have that greasy sensation, your skin absorbs it very quickly. And another thing I've noticed is that even though it's very creamy and it's thick, it doesn't feel heavy on your skin, which I find very refreshing, because in my experience, whenever I've used very heavy creams, I can feel it all on my skin, and it just takes a lot longer to absorb, if at all. And so, how does your skin feel? Much better. Great. Very happy to enjoy these products. And again, they are very easy to use, very effective, but as you've noticed, it is indeed a very exquisite skin treatment. lets you know. After every application, I always like to present you with 10 to 15 minutes of relaxation, and usually in our spa we like to use the very soft music, but this time we would like to try something a little bit different, and that is a short guided visualization. And I'm going to be using a tablet to play this short story, and I've also changed the settings on the tablet so that it emits red light instead of the blue light, as the blue light prevents you from falling asleep, and the red light is much more gentler on the eyes. And I don't want to interrupt your state of relaxation, so just relax a little more, and I hope that you enjoy the story. And when it's done, if you need some extra time, go right ahead. When you're ready, you can meet me at the front desk. Enjoy. In a very faraway land, there is a village located very close to a desert. The inhabitants of this village, their skin reflects the land. Many of them have sunburnt skin. It's dry. But they use their local herbs to heal their wounds and maintain their health as much as possible. But the inhabitants, every now and then, speak of an oasis. They don't know its location. For the people who have been there say that it just magically appeared. And the reason why they are sure of its existence is because the people who have been there have returned with beautiful skin and any other health issues that they were experiencing has completely healed. And most recently, there have been a few of the inhabitants who claim they have been to the oasis. Some said that while they were crossing the desert, the oasis just simply appeared. While others said that while they were camping in the desert, when they went to sleep at night, when they woke up, they were in the middle of the oasis. Now it does sound like there are different ways to get there, or for the oasis to find them. But one thing has definitely been the same, is what they see when they are in the oasis. They tell of a lagoon covered in rose petals, which change color from pink to white to purple to red and yellow. These are just a few of the colors. around the lagoon are animals. And this is where they drink their water or bathe in it or just frolic around. Under the moonlight, these petals shimmer. Under the sunlight, their colors are just simply vibrant. When the inhabitants saw the lagoon, they said that there was this feeling of déjà vu, almost as if this place knew them, or they have been there before. And they felt right at home. And so they just walked into the lagoon. And they noticed that it wasn't deep. It was actually shallow waters. But it just seemed much more vast, and maybe it is, we don't know. And so they just sat there and dipped their hands into the water, and they could hear the water say, let them take away everything that ails you. Just gently feel the water drip down from the top of your head, running down your nose, touching your lips, traveling down your chest, your arms, your fingers, and your legs. Let them do their work. You are here because this is a gift for you. The more they used the water, they noticed that it was also inducing sleep. And slowly and deeply, they fell asleep. And when they they were back where they had started. And indeed, they noticed that they felt so much better. And even though some of them thought that maybe it had been a dream, they quickly realized their skin was infused with the aroma of roses, a beautiful flower that is not commonly found in their village. And so, these stories inspire in search of this oasis. And those who really want it, who really